Whether you're starting your 3D printing journey or you're already a seasoned maker, finding the right printer can be a game changer. And today we're diving into the Bambu Lab A1 Mini, a compact powerhouse that promises to deliver for everyone, no matter your experience level. So in this full review, I'll be putting it through its paces to see if it truly lives up to the hype. Is it just another beginner printer, or does it offer something for everybody? Let's find out. So this is the Bambu Lab A1 Mini, and I have it here in its base configuration, and it's only $199. Now, I did pay for this myself at full price at that $199. This is not a sponsored video or anything like this. This is my personal machine. Now, at $199, I feel like this is kind of a bit of a no-brainer for just starting out in 3D printing. Now, just because this is gonna be good for somebody starting out in the printing, it doesn't mean it's not gonna be good for someone who's a seasoned 3D printer. Now, you can spring for the AMS Lite, and that would bring the price up to $349, and there is a small part of me that wish that I did do that. If you were to purchase the AMS Lite separately, it's another $249. So if you buy it bundled up with the printer, you're actually saving a good chunk of change. Now, basically what the AMS Lite would do is it would give you the ability to do the multicolor printing or the multi-material printing. Now, one of the reasons I like having the AMS on my X1 Carbon is the fact that I can just load up different color filaments and different type of filaments in there, and I can just remotely print without having to actually come over and switch them out as I need. Now, when I first got into 3D printing, I started with a Sobel SV06, which did not go great. And thankfully, I got kind of bit by the 3D printing bug that made me want to actually continue with this hobby and with this journey, I would say. Now, if this was around when I had just started getting to 3D printing, I would have easily sprung for this, because the amount of features and the speed of this printer far exceeds anything else in that $199 price range. Now, what makes this the Mini is the fact that it has such a smaller build volume. Now, for instance, here's a build plate for the X1 Carbon, and this is the build plate for the A1 Mini. And as you can see, the build plate is significantly smaller. So the build volume on the A1 Mini is 180 cubed, which means you have 180, 180, and it'll print 180 millimeters off the bed. Whereas the X1 Carbon or any of the other Core XYs from Bambu, like the P1P or the P1S, has a 256 cubed build volume. So it is quite a bit smaller than the bigger printers, but you know what? That doesn't make it worse. It was nice to see that Bambu did ship this with a double-sided PEI textured build plate. So having the limited build space of the 180 cubed, you are gonna have some trouble printing some things, but for a lot of things, it's perfectly adequate. Like check out this guy right here. This is a cool little flexible print from Flexi Factory. This whole thing printed in place on the build plate. So you are able to get some large prints on this as long as you get a little creative. Now, most of the time I'm using this for prototyping some smaller stuff, so the build volume isn't too much of a concern for me. But if you're into cosplay, you're not gonna really benefit from having this small of a printer. You probably wanna look at the A1, the normal size, not the Mini, which has a normal size build plate. So with a smaller printer, if you do live in a place where you can only kind of get away with a smaller footprint and you only have limited space, the A1 Mini is probably gonna be your ticket. So now what's crazy to me is just how much features are packed into this printer. You have automatic Z offset, you have automatic mesh bed leveling, you've got vibration resonance to help keep the printing quiet, and it's even got active flow rate compensation built into the extruder area. And basically that's just gonna help you get better prints all the time. Now, I will say the auto mesh bed leveling has actually given me some problems, and it was a little bit frustrating to be honest. I would have to send a print like 4 times in a row to get it to finally go through. I don't know what has been causing it to do that. It's hit or miss. It'll work perfectly fine for such a long time, and then all of a sudden it'll just keep throwing me that error. and I'll just come over and kind of mess with the build plate and it'll eventually fix itself. Now, just like it's a more expensive, bigger brothers and sisters, is that this does have Wi-Fi printing from the computer app or the phone app. So what's super cool is that you can just actually go on your phone, load up Maker World, and just tell it to print a file from the website straight off your phone. That's super cool. I really like that. And you know, the app for the computer is also really nice. And the fact that you can control multiple printers all from there so seamlessly, it's really nice. So now, like I mentioned before, I like to take this printer back and forth from work. I typically will bring it home on the weekends. And while it does have that Wi-Fi printing, I wish they would fix this one thing. The printer only can remember one Wi-Fi at a time. So that means when I bring it home, I have to remove the old Wi-Fi. I have to add in the new Wi-Fi. And same thing again, when I get to work, I have to do that flip-flop. I wish you would be able to store multiple Wi-Fis on this. So now it is really nice also to see that it does have a small little color touchscreen. So you can actually move around the systems fairly easily. Now I have found that the screen can be a little laggy very occasionally. It doesn't happen very often, but sometimes it's just got a super slow frame rate. One other quick little cool feature about this printer is the fact that with Bambu Lab, replacement parts are so easily available on the website. You know, I've seen some horror stories where people are trying to get replacement parts and it can be a pain sometimes. So the fact that they have all the parts readily available with like right to repair in a sense, I really like that. This does also have filament handling sensors, so it will detect if you run out of filament, but also more importantly, it will alert you if your filament has tangled. The print quality between this and say my Bambu Lab X1 Carbon is negligible. The print quality off this printer is phenomenal. It's so good. I actually haven't really been able to tell a difference between the two printers. If you take a look at this pumpkin that I designed, it actually printed so nicely. Even the top isn't too bad. Now, keep in mind, I designed this myself. I'm not an expert designer, so I probably could have done a little bit better on designing this overhang area. But if you look, that's kind of a tough place to print, and it still looks really good. Now, back to this flexi dinosaur here. Same thing, it just looks so good. It printed beautifully. And now, speaking of comparing the two printers, the speed difference between this and the X1 Carbon, there is a bit of a speed difference, but it's really not all that much. This printer by itself is so fast at printing. So yeah, the print speed on this is super good. It is super fast. Now, numbers off the top of my head, I wanna say this is good for about 10,000 movements per second or something like that, where the X1 Carbon is 20,000. So it's the X1's definitely faster, but this is still really fast. So now I started up a print to do a benchy so you could hear how quiet it is while I go ahead and finish out talking here. So like I said, this is not an enclosed printer, obviously, but that is going to limit you in what you can print. So you are going to be kind of stuck with the PLA, the PETG, the TPU. You're not going to be able to do any of the more like exotic materials, say like ABS, ASA, stuff like that. It does have a built-in camera so you can actually remotely view and keep an eye on your print. Now, I'll be honest with you here, you might as well not even have it to a certain point. It's bad. It's super low frame rate. It's not very easy to see what's happening. Now, you can see if your print messes up, but that's about as far as you would go with it, to be honest. It does do the time lapses as well. I haven't had too much luck getting some nicer time lapses out of it, but it does have it, so if you're interested in using it, it is included. And also, if the normal speeds are not fast enough for you, you can actually come in here and enable sport or ludicrous mode. Now, ludicrous mode, you're definitely going to see some loss of quality because it's just too fast. Sport, you can actually get away with pretty easily, I found, if you use the active flow calibration. Like here, we're gonna go ahead and go sport. It's gonna go a little bit faster now, and I'm gonna switch it over to ludicrous. And now it's just going literally ludicrously fast. So much, we're probably gonna see some problems with the print here. And this is real-time speed. I have not actually sped this up at all. So there we have it, a Benchy printed in the Elegoo Black Galaxy PLA. And actually on the top, you can see it didn't do too bad on ludicrous mode. That's actually pretty good looking, I would say. What do you guys think? Let me know. I really think that this is gonna be probably one of the best printers that you can get as a beginner. Or, you know, it's gonna be even valuable for experienced users despite a couple minor things. But yeah, let me know what you think about this printer down in the comments below. Was this your first printer that you ever started out with? I'd love to hear it. Actually, you know what? What printer did you start with? That's what I want to know. Let me know down in the comments below. This is Adam from the Rad Dad Print Lab. I'll see you next time.